And Mother's Day is almost full swing here. It should be closer to lunchtime. So we're coming up out of this Monsanto made corn. I walked all the way over there. Walked along that tree line to approximately there and just started coming across the field. And there's the heathens. Here they come. A little bit doesn't even know where to go. She's just going out there, one barking. Alrighty. That's what the garden looks like from the west end. You guys don't even know where I'm at. Little bit just goes out barking when Lucy's like, where's Petey? Where's Petey? Huh. Oh, okay. They go a little bit back. It's not quite even. It's like the right side is slightly down. Oh, wow. Mom's swing I'm going to sit in for a few minutes here. Relax, looking at the garden. Whew. Oh, ow, ow, ow. Yeah. Supposed to rain this evening. Supposed to rain quite a bit for the next 3 or 4 days. It's going to rain off and on, I think. I don't have nothing in garden number 2 over there yet. I'm waiting for the tomatoes to get a little bit bigger. Might end up, I hate doing it too, Lowe's, I think it was. I don't recall now the store. It was not China Mart though, but they had, it says heirloom grown tomatoes, which were about the size, almost the size of those tomatillos right there. Okay, that's the first two things right there, is tomatillos in the cages. I can't see anything you can find over crap. But anyway, might buy about 4 of those. Or actually might, yeah, 4 and put in those 5-gallon buckets we bought. Tracy wanted to put them on the porch, grow them. So we'll do that. But get our tomatoes, everything from seed out here. The zucchini is doing good. The okra looks better, but it's still just, but again, remember, this is May 10th. Now until the end of May is when most people start planting. I mean, if you're going from seed, a lot of people will plant in the house around now and put it out in the middle of June. You know, but there are people that got stuff ahead of me too, which is cool for them, but this is the first year with plastic we've used, and it seems like it's done a major, major plus. The ground is not even. We don't have a lot of equipment to work with. Old tiller that we have to try to make as even as possible as we can with a bow rake by hand. And we put the plastic down and, you know, put some fertilizer. Every time I was suggested when I planted seeds to dig down about 4 to 6 inches, put a little bit of 15-15-15 fertilizer, put a little soil in, and then you can either put lime in, or I mix my lime in there with my potting soil. And the potting soil is better than the garden soil. I don't give a shit what anybody says. That garden soil is chips, and it's got the soft, like, it almost looks like fluff. And I've got coffee cans and other planters too, so it's not the coffee can. And nothing is growing through that stuff. Nothing. It's almost like it deflects the water. It soaks in, but no. I got some potting soil growing like no problem. So I'm not saying that you can't use garden soil or any of the other, I mean, potting soil or any of the garden soil. But I use, well, I mean, gosh. See, I got myself twisted around here. Potting soil is the one that looks like dirt. That's what I use. That to me has worked better than anything else. I've seen results myself. If you want to use garden soil or garden mulch or garden mix or whatever other than potting soil, have at it. You know, maybe you were doing something different or adding something to it. I don't know. I use nothing but just basic stuff. I put a little lime inside the potting soil and mix it around. Dig the hole, put a 15-15-15 fertilizer down, put a little soil or that potting soil down, and then the soil just usually with the plant in the planters in the ground. and everything has come up really good. It's, most of that stuff is from seed though. But as far as the stuff I transplanted from planters, been those tomatillos. I just thought about that. This is all coming from seed. Those tomatillos are the only thing that had are in planters because I used the garden mix and all the other crap. That's why nothing came out really good. You know, I got tomato plant that's in that stuff that's coming out so-so, but I made enough. I made 18 more with the garden soil, and that's see how that happens now. It's the 10th of May. I did this like about 4 or 5 days ago, and there's already three of them that you see starting to come above the soil. So again, I'll use garden soil. You use whatever the heck you want. Garden soil seems to work perfect for me with heirloom seeds. So, CJ's not here for Lucy for Mother's Day. Poor little girl. I miss that little girl. She was born April 23rd, 2006. And we had to have put down December 17th, 2013. She had cancer. Thanks, man, God. Yeah, thank you for all of it. So, grow yourself some food if you want to eat some healthy food. You go to China Mart and buy that food, you're gambling. It's on a 1 to 10 nutrition with my stuff being 10. That stuff's probably 2 to 3, if that. The organic stuff might be higher, but you don't know. You don't know unless you grow something yourself. You don't know what they sprayed on it. If it's organic, if it is organic, what else did they use in it? You know, I mean, again, unless you grow anything, you don't know what you're eating. And like I said, living in a big city before and coming down here is night and day. I have family down here, and I came down here when my mom was ill and stayed. She passed away, and I'm staying. I'm not going. You couldn't get me in a big city. I don't give a shit what this mafia tells anybody. You have to live here. You know, that's the thing. Why? Why are they so hell-bent on getting everybody to do certain things? Why are they so hell-bent of trying to unarm the people? Maybe something major is going to happen. They don't want you to be able to fight back. Yeah, that's how I look at it. Call me paranoid.